you talked about conflict in data, right?
Yeah, like what happens when I have a study. What do
That's
we do?
Right. So here's what happens. Science, a lot of people misinterpret what science is. They say science is a fact. Science is not a fact. Science is a field of study. Now, there are some things that are scientific facts, like gravity, okay? But science is a field of study. And I do think sometimes scientists do themselves an injustice when they do not describe science as such. It is a field of study. Now, what does that field of study mean? It means you study the field. So what's the field of science? All of these research surveys, these research, these laboratory experiments, these real world research experiments, that's the field of study. And so for you and I, who are reading the data from these experts, mm-hmm. what we typically depend on is what is the majority sentiment? What is the consensus among the scientist community? And that is how we start to derive our conclusions based on the research that we're able to analyze independently as independent thinking individuals. Now, you can still believe an outlier study if you choose. It is contrary to the majority of the science that's available for review, but that is still within your right as an American, right? So that is how you do it. You're gonna always have clashing opinions and conclusions, but literally in research, there's no 50-50 here. There's not 50% of the scientists are saying this and 50% of the scientists are saying that. Literally, you're giving me 7% of what scientists are saying compared to 92-93% of what other scientists are saying. That's the argument that you're making with me, Charlie.
And I'm always fascinated by the 7% because they're willing to buck the consensus and pursue things that they have found in the scientific method to be true. And so I guess this is an important question. Then we'll get into what do we do when we have these differences, because that we're going to keep on going in circles of study versus study. And I'm going to say, well, according to this doctor, for mm-hmm. example, as I'll say, Dr. Derone, Delta variant, not severe in children. And then I'll say, Dr. DeBazzi said the same thing, and Dr. Macri. And you'll say, well, the CDC said this. I guess I'll ask you
Which
a question.
Which are a lot of doctors.
Well, let me ask you a question. The CDC contradicted themselves on masks. They contradicted themselves on vaccines. They contradicted themselves on COVID being on surfaces. Remember, they said it could be there up to 5 days. We know that not to be true. They contradicted themselves on almost everything. If they've been wrong on the science of 90% of doctors, why should we trust them now?
You know, that's really interesting because you trust them, don't you?
It depends on what issue.
Exactly. That's my point.
Yeah. So
you trust them depending on what issue. That is called confirmation bias. So, Charlie.
Well, it depends on the issue. If they're talking about, Newton's second law, then I'll trust them on that.
They don't talk about that. The issue with the CDC is not about you discrediting all the scientists. Now, I take it back to one variable you just named, the COVID, the survival time of the virus, right?
Yeah, like is COVID able to be on this table for 5 days?
Right. Initially, there were scientists that came out and said, hell, it can be up there for 18 days. Well, in certain environments it can, because that was based on a ship crew, a cruise ship, where the virus was still there after
the Princess 15
days.
Ship.
That's right, brother. It was there after 15 days. Everybody was evacuated. They cleaned that ship top to bottom, and they still found active virus on the ship. So they came out and said, hey, listen, we're still learning this thing. We are connecting it to the field of study, which is called science. And we want you to be warned that we have active virus cultures still on this ship, and no one infected has been here for over 15 days. They reported that. And then people ran with it and said, oh my goodness, this thing survives for all of these days. But that was in a particular environment, and that environment was conducive to the growth and the preservation of that virus. That's context that's important.